Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the number of signals that are observed in a carbon-13 NMR and what that information tells us about a molecule. So in the carbon-13 NMR, you'll see a unique peak for every unique carbon that is present in the molecule. We don't see any signals from hydrogens, only carbons, because that's the nuclei that we're looking at in this type of spectroscopy. So you get one signal or one peak for every unique type of carbon in your molecule. We'll write us a note here, one signal for every unique carbon. So we really just mean every carbon that is in a unique chemical environment. And so if we look at this molecule that's shown on the left here, I'm going to start outside the ring next to the carbonyl. So this would be carbon 1. This is carbon 2. It will show up in the carbon-13 NMR. It doesn't have any protons on it, but that doesn't matter, okay? So that's unique. There's no symmetry in this molecule. So every single carbon here is going to have its own unique signal at a given chemical shift. So this particular carbon-13 spectrum would show me 9 signals. So let's take a look at another example of a molecule. This molecule has the molecular formula C7H14O. So I know there's 7 carbons, but how many signals am I going to see in the carbon-13 NMR? Symmetry can make it so that I see less signals than I have carbons, and that tells me that there should be groups on the molecule that are in identical chemical environments. So if I start numbering on the left here, I'd say 1, 2, 3, 4, I go to the end of the chain, 5. Those are all different, but then if I look at these other two methyl groups, they're also coming off of carbon 4, and there's free rotation because these are all sigma-type bonds. And so those 3 methyls that I have labeled 5 are all in an identical chemical environment. So instead of seeing 3 unique peaks for them, I'm going to see 1 peak because of the symmetry. So one way that symmetry shows up is when groups are coming off of the same carbon. So tert-butyl groups, isopropyl groups, that's one way that we can see symmetry in a molecule, and that will be reflected in our carbon-13 NMR. This carbon-13 NMR would have 5 signals, even though there are 7 carbons. So the number of signals can do a lot in terms of putting together a structure because you can understand whether there's symmetry in the molecule or not, and then use that information as you solve a puzzle. So I want to look at one more example that involves symmetry. In this case, it's a plane of symmetry, sort of down the middle of the molecule in this instance, that makes for less signals than we have carbons because there's identical chemical environments. So if I start numbering here, I'd say 1, 2, 3, but then if I go this way, this carbon is 4, but so is the carbon across from it on the benzene ring. They're both next door to the ethyl group, and they're both 1 away from the carbonyl group. When you look at groups coming off of a ring, it can look like they're sort of oriented in one position, but there's free rotation about sigma bonds. So the bond between 2 and 3 is freely rotating. The carbon 1 is not stuck on one side. And so those two carbon 4s are in identical chemical environments. So then next would be 2 carbon 5s across from one another. Then carbon 6, carbon 7, and carbon 8. So this molecule would see a total of 8 signals, even though it has 10 carbons, and that's because there's an element of symmetry. In this particular example, it's not coming off of the same group, it's not carbons coming off the same groups, it's that there's a plane of symmetry within the molecule. And this is the other type of symmetry that can result in less signals than you would expect given a molecular formula. So this has been a look at carbon-13 NMR and the number of signals in a spectrum and what that tells us about the structure of a molecule. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.